So mind wandering is a mental experience that most people are intimately familiar with, whether we're sitting in a classroom, watching television, watching a movie, having a conversation with a close friend. At times you might notice that you start thinking about something that's completely unrelated to what's going on in the moment. And researchers in psychology are really trying to understand what this phenomenon means. When you look into the educational literature, usually it'll tell you that mind wandering is associated with negative learning outcomes in the classroom. I think a lot of parents are worried if they ever hear that their child is maybe not necessarily able to focus their attention as they sit in a classroom. And so there's a lot of important reasons why we would want to understand why mind wandering happens and how we can mitigate its influence in learning. And so what our lab does is we try to understand mind wandering in lecture-based settings, particularly in university settings, where when you talk to students and you ask them what is the number one problem that you have with learning in the classroom, they'll say, I just can't pay attention for 40 or 60 or 120 minutes. And so we want to try to help them to do that. And our approach has been to try to figure out what we can do to help students stay focused. Usually when someone's sitting in a lecture-based setting, they know that they're not going to be responsible for expressing what they've learned until days or weeks or even months later once they get to a midterm or a final exam. And what we want to do is change that around and set up situations where during even a single lecture, if we ask students questions every now and then interspersed through the lecture, is that going to help them to pay better attention? So if you set up a situation where the student knows that at any given moment during the lecture, they might actually be responsible for expressing what they've learned, is that actually going to change in any way how well they're able to approach that situation? And what our research shows is that this helps tremendously. So just the simple act of asking students questions every now and then during one lecture can significantly reduce the occurrence of mind wandering. It helps students to learn the information in a more effective manner. And there's a lot of other benefits that you might not necessarily think would come about from this type of intervention. So for instance, a lot of students would be worried about test anxiety. If we're testing people every lecture when they come into the classroom, is that in any way going to make students who don't like taking tests less likely to take a course like that? And our research tries to address this as well as we can. One thing that we find is that by giving brief tests during a classroom setting, when students get to a more substantial test later on, such as a midterm or a final exam, they actually express that they're less anxious about those tests because by having tests presented throughout the course of the year that are more low stakes, it just makes them more used to the idea of the types of questions they're going to be getting. When we ask students, how difficult was it for you to learn from a lecture where they're being tested throughout, students actually report that they find it much easier to get through a course like that because they realize that I don't have to try to keep everything in mind throughout the course of the entire lecture. I can actually have a chance to offload what I've learned and focus on what's coming next. And that seems to help students quite a lot. Now, I think that one thing that is really important to note as well is that a lot of people will say that is all mind wandering actually bad? What if the student is thinking about something related to the lecture or their course in terms of what's going on in their own lives? Wouldn't that be something that we really want them to do? Don't we want them to be able to apply what they're learning in the real world? So why do we want to get rid of mind wandering? And those are great questions. And at the end of the day, mind wandering can be good and it can be bad. And one thing that we really are going to want to try to figure out in our own work is how we can direct mind wandering in ways that actually help students to learn the materials. If we come into a lecture-based setting and we just start talking about our topic without actually considering where the students are coming from and not trying to meet them at their level, then you can be assured that whatever they're thinking about is oftentimes going to be completely unrelated to the lecture. But if you can relate the content in some way to their own interests, then one thing that our research actually shows that you can do is you can direct their mind wandering in more effective ways, such that as they're thinking about things from outside of the lecture, they're actually able to still keep the lecture in mind, and that can actually benefit learning. And I think one really important point that this underscores is that the onus isn't necessarily on the student. Our brains did not evolve to sit still for 1 hour at a time, paying attention to as much information as we can. The onus here really falls on the teacher and how they approach structuring their learning materials for the students. And so whether that means organizing the lecture in terms of information that's relevant to the students and their own lives, or using these types of interpolated testing interventions where we can actually reduce mind wandering when it's not good. Again, it's up to the teacher to do what they can to help the student take in information as well as they can.